Hey everybody, welcome to the lounge. All my fellow loungers, chillers, bowlers, and grillers. Today's fan mail at the lounge. We're going to jump right into it, but first I just want to let you know I actually opened all the letters up first, so that this way I don't have to go through that process. The first one's from Alex. This envelope was all tore up when I got it. So, let's see what you got to say, Alex. I am writing you to, I have to take my glasses off. Oh, and just one more thing. A lot of people have been saying, who the hell takes their glasses off? Me, that's who. I'm nearsighted, I have problems with distance, but reading wise, if I take them off, I can read just fine, so. I am writing you from the Big Apple. Whom do you prefer? Billy Joel, Elton John, Beach Boys, or Vanilla Ice? Out of those four, it's a tie between Billy Joel and Elton John. Never cared for the Beach Boys. Don't care for Vanilla Ice either. I think, what do you have, one good song? And was it really good? Anyway, let's go Rangers. Pull tab on pen. Well, obviously, don't know what you're talking about because there's no pen. Hope all is well. Tell Jesse I said hi. Hope you and JT get along and it would make everything better. P.S. Keep this flashlight with you. Alex, the Juggy Caroni. There was no flashlight in here. Like I said, this is how the envelope came all tore up. You have to remember that's what happens when you send things inside of an envelope. Sometimes they can just disappear before I ever get it. So, all right, let's go to the next one. If anybody's saying, you know, Uncle Larry, you look down today. No, I'm not down. I'm perfectly fine. I'm just really, really tired. I still haven't recovered from basketball the other day. We played 4-on-4 full court quite a few games, so I'm really tired. All right, this one. I got a patch in here from Panama City Beach Stair Climb FDNY Memorial. And a firefighter, I guess it's a commemorative coin or something. That's pretty awesome. Can't wait to read this one. Hey Uncle Larry, I'm a firefighter, EMT from Florida. I'm also a chiller, griller, and baller. Congrats on your recent 300,000 subscribers. I tried finding you my old first responder patch, but couldn't. Instead, I gave you a sticker I got last September during the all-stair climb. We had to climb 110 stories over here in Panama City Beach to simulate what FDNY had to go through. Wow, 110 stories. And I just complain about playing like 5 games of basketball. It makes me feel pretty stupid right now. We wore our full bunker gear and toughed it out. I got a few t-shirts and stuff, but none in your size. I also attached a challenge coin. Google it and you'll understand what it is. Fire Ice is the company one of my family members works for. It is pretty much a fire retardant service. It is truly amazing. Check it out. Love from Rosewood Fire Department. Keep up the great videos, Uncle Larry. Wow, thank you so much for this letter and this stuff, and I will Google it and find out what that is. Also, thank you for your service of what you do, because it's guys like you who are really the true heroes in the United States, the people who are serving other people like that. That's awesome. Okay, let's see. I have to make sure I don't show the envelope like this, because it's like, Uncle Larry, you showed the address. It's like, yeah, there's too much stuff to remember all the time. Dear Larry's Lounge, my name is Caleb, and I love your videos. The first video of yours I saw was Chilling and Grilling 6, Lamb Chops. I really want to try your food. So after I write this letter, I'm going to ask my mom to make it. I'm really sorry that Jeffrey destroyed your sign. Yeah, me too. I hope you get a new one, eventually. Right now I have a piece of cardboard up there. I have gotten a couple signs, but the only one that's going to replace my sign is the one that I make. My dad is a bit of a cook himself, and he makes really good pot roast. I put the recipe on the back if you want to try it. Hopefully you can read this in fan mail at the lounge 5 or 6. Sincerely, Caleb. P.S. Sorry for my bad handwriting. Your handwriting's not that bad. I could read it, so it's not that bad. So anyway, so your pot roast, I will definitely look into this when I get a chance to and see if I can't make that. Try it out. I always like to try new stuff, so. All right, well, my SD card just messed up again and it stopped recording. I looked up at the camera and it had stopped. I have no idea when. I have to apologize to anybody whose letter got cut off because I'm gonna have to edit that. It absolutely sucks. Somebody told me what's going on. I gotta buy different cards. Anyway, this one's from Dustin. Hey Uncle Larry, I've basically watched all your videos, but I have a few to go. You are like my video cookbook. Sorry if that sounds weird. Plus, I hope in the future I can buy one of your shirts and hats. I do have a question. Will you grill any breakfast? I most probably will at some point. My name is Dustin. I'm also a fellow YouTuber. I'm 16, but still enjoy your content. I do have a different type of channel. My YouTube name is Dustin Watkins. If you want to go check it out, if you'd like. If it's not any trouble, can you give me a shout out? You just kind of got one. Well, I hope you write back, but if not, then I'm fine with that. Thank you for reading this. Sincerely, Dustin. P.S. I'm not a drawer, so I did what I could. I wish I didn't have to fold it, though. Yeah, the shout outs that I give will only be if you write it in a letter, because if I had to give a shout out to every person, I've said this in countless other videos, that it would like take forever. Larry's Lounge. Loungers, chillers, bowlers, and grillers. There it is. Nice. Thank you so much. Thank you for your letter. And I appreciate it. If you can see all the sweat stains, it's hot out today. Okay. Here we go. Dear Uncle Larry, you're way more better being a father than Psycho Dad. I'm sorry about how Jeffrey treated you during the Kung Fu skit. He acts like a 5-year-old. Some of his brain connections isn't functioning right. Tom is really awesome and Garfunkel is really cute, even though she looks like a mop. Yeah, she does kind of look like a mop, doesn't she? I like cats. I'm a cat person. I showed some clips of Garfunkel to my dad. My dad, a Gulf War veteran. Hope you're having a good day, from Christopher. Christopher, tell your dad that I said thank you for his service. The reason why this country is so great as it is because of men like him. So I thank you. Okay, here we go. Let's see what we got here. We got all kinds of stuff. Dear Larry, I don't know if I should call you Uncle Larry. Feel free to call me Uncle Larry. I've been an uncle ever since I was like 10 years old, so it doesn't bother me in the least bit. I'm very comfortable with that. Hello, my name is Alex. I'm going to keep this short and sweet because personally, I don't like reading long letters. Me and you both, but I've been trying. This is the first fan mail that I've ever sent to anyone. Wow, that's awesome. You're my idol. I love how you're caring for everyone. I have some questions for you. How old were you when you got into basketball? I think I've answered that quite a few times. And it's probably like 8 years old. And I'm guessing at that age, I know I was very young. My brothers taught me how to play. Did you get your recipes from your father, and did he get it from his father, etc.? Some of the recipes that I do are family recipes. I don't think I've gotten any of my recipes from my dad, though. Some of them aren't. Some of them are just like when I watch the Food Network or I saw something I really liked, and then I'll add it or change something a little bit to it just to make it my own. And never be afraid to experiment with different spices and stuff like that and try things, different things out. Are you thinking of getting any social media accounts such as Twitter and Instagram? That brings up a great point. I'm glad that you actually said that. I just had gotten a message through work from somebody whose son bought a t-shirt or was buying a t-shirt that they donated money to one of those fake ass Uncle Larry's on Twitter because they said that if you give money they'll give a an autograph for it. I would never charge money for an autograph. It's just my signature. If anybody wants my autograph, I'd be more than happy to do it. If you bought a t-shirt and you wanted it signed, make sure you just say that. I'll sign the t-shirt or a bandana or a hat or whatever. I have no problem with that. If you wanted it through the mail, the only way I'm going to send it to you is if you send me a self-addressed stamped envelope for me to send it back. I'd be more than happy to do that if you wanted that. You know, personally, I don't understand why anybody wants my autograph. But I just want you guys to know that, since she brought up about Twitter, I do not have Twitter. I do not have Instagram. Don't know if I'm ever going to get either one of them. But if I did, believe me, I will make a public announcement on a video. So remember, keep away from them fake-ass Uncle Larrys. Also, as a little idea for your channel, can you do a Q&A or a Chillin' and Growing with Jesse's dad? That's not going to happen. Also, can you autograph the picture I sent you from you, Tom, and Jesse? Can you also... Oh. I forgot that he sent... There's Tom. There's Jesse. And there's me. And I would love to, if you would have sent me a self-stamped envelope with these pictures, I would have. And for now on, I also want to make another announcement. I would be more than willing, I most probably will do this for you, Alex, this time, but in the future, please send me a self-stamped envelope, self-addressed stamped envelope. I am not going to ask for Jesse to sign anything. It's just too much for me to get a hold of him. The best way I could say is, you know, send him a letter, try to get his autograph that way, but I'm not going to be going back and forth. So if you want mine, it's fine. If you want Jesse's, that's quite different. So keep that in mind, guys. I'll put that aside. Me and Tom will be happy to send those. Okay, here's a baseball card from Juan Berenger of Atlanta. Not a big Atlanta fan, because I like the Phillies, but Atlanta's always has been a really good team. Dear Uncle Larry, hi, my name is Tanner. I live in the state of Washington. I wanted to let you know that you make my day. Awesome. I love to watch your videos. I love your basketball videos. They taught me a lot of new and cool stuff. My favorite is In the Gaming with Tom. I also like the skits. P.S. Number one fan. Thank you, Tanner, and I appreciate the card. And thank you for the mail. My number one fan. Okay, this is from Isaac. Looks like he's from California. Uncle Larry, sorry for the bad handwriting. My name is Isaac. I may not be old enough to open the same beverage as you, but I love your videos. I might not have as bad days as some of your other viewers, but they sure do make me happy. I have one question. Is it true that you will make your lounge bigger, extending all the way to your pool, like you mentioned one time? Be sure to check out Rooster Teeth Productions and their series called RT Shorts. They are funny like your skits. Sincerely, Isaac, or my YouTube user, Mr. Chief 117. Is it true that I will make my lounge bigger? Yeah, I said that. I think I said it one or two videos ago. Yeah, I plan on going out this way eventually. Well, actually, my grill over there is going to have a countertop and everything. I am going to go out this way with another level, probably one step up higher, and it's going to have eventually a hot tub on it, and then that'll have a pathway leading to a deck that's going to go to the other side of my pool. That's my plan. When it gets done, I'm not really sure. I have to have the time and the extra funds for that, but when I do that, I'll be pretty excited about it because I really would like to have a hot tub. Okay, so here's from... I thought I cut all of them open. Obviously, I didn't. From Jonathan. This one already came with a slit in it. So I hope you didn't send me anything, because if you did, it's most probably not in here. Hi, Uncle Larry. My name is Jonathan. I've been a subscriber ever since you did Welcome to Larry's Lounge. I love your Chillin' and Grillin' series. Your chicken sandwiches were delicious. I really appreciate you taking the time to read this and featuring it on your fan mail. I really appreciate the time that you took to write this, too. P.S. I would appreciate if you and Tom could sign this and return it. I will provide a stamp for it. I also included a bottle opener. Hopefully you can use it daily. Well, the bottle opener obviously did not make it. Let me see if the stamp did. I think there's something else in here. No, well, there's another piece of paper in here. Oh, there is a stamp in here. I don't know how I'm going to peel that off and put that back on the envelope, but please accept this bottle opener as a gift to you for my recent vacation to Florida. Cheers, drink responsible. Thank you for that. Unfortunately, your bottle opener didn't make it. It got opened and somebody took it out of there. Probably because when you send something like that through the regular mail, it's a sharp object and somebody's going to open it and take it out of there. Your stamp did make it, however, and I will definitely have me and Tom sign that and we will send that back to you. It's a shame because I would have really enjoyed a bottle opener from Florida. I will put that one aside. Dear Uncle Larry, my name is Michael. I am 14 years old from New Jersey. And I love your channel. Whenever I'm watching your episodes from Chillin' and Grillin', I just want to eat my laptop. Tell Tom and Jesse I said hi, and maybe even Mr. Ridgway. P.S. I hope he's not that angry all the time. Plus, this is my first fan mail letter. Hope to see you on the web. Oh, and upload some basketball episodes in the meantime. Sit back and have a cold one. Certainly will do. I did upload a basketball video yesterday, so I at least did that for you so far. And a matter of fact, that's for you, buddy. Is Mr. Ridgway mad all the time? No, he's not. So, I mean, I just was on vacation with him. He wasn't mad all the time. Okay. This is a long one. Might not read all this to you. It's your loyal fan from Texas again. I guess it's weird that I keep sending you fan mail, but the truth is that I really appreciate your channel. You remind me of my own Uncle Larry, even though you two are pretty different. He never wore a hat or a mustache or glasses, and he preferred old Western movies to comedies. I actually like old Western movies too, but I like comedies, probably more. His real name was Lawrence. My real name is Lawrence, but it's not spelled like that at all. His is L-A-W-R-E-N-C-E, which is the most common. Mine is actually pronounced Lawrence, which is L-O-R-E-N-Z. And maybe yours too. Okay, but we always call him Larry. Same with me. All right, really, he wasn't blood related to me, but I loved him like family, and I know he felt the same way about me. I lost him on Halloween in 2013 and really miss him. He loved fishing and hunting and being outdoors with Mother Nature. He was a very gentle man and had a caring disposition that made him easy to like. I guess I see the same caring side of you. I worked up the nerve to ask him to take me hunting because I'd never been before and had been too shy to ask. Even though I knew he'd say yes, he passed away before he could get a chance to take me. I used to fish when I was a little kid, maybe 8 or so. I picked up a little green branch that had just been pruned off a crepe myrtle tree and attached a line and little bobber to hook to one end with a little help. I have a hectic home life. My family's pretty crazy, so I was really glad, even at the age, to have a reason to be quiet and outside by myself. Yes, there's traffic again, I know. I'd like to go again, but I wouldn't know what the heck I'm doing now, and I'd actually be pretty embarrassed to be a beginner at my age. Maybe I'll get over it. Yeah, you should, because I don't know what your age is, but don't worry about it. Just go to a tackle and bait store and tell them that you're just starting out. They'll steer you in the right direction. Go out and try it. I'm telling you, you'll have fun. It's actually, it's best to be like a beginner, because if you're like a beginner, you go in there and say, I don't know what I'm doing. Then they'll be like so willing to teach you everything and tell you everything what you should do. I tell you all that to tell you I absolutely love the fishing with Uncle Larry up Blue from the Outer Banks. It was so peaceful that I too forgot my stress for a while. It was calming and beautiful to me for a lot of different reasons that you can probably figure out from what I already wrote. So I just wanted to tell you thanks for putting it up. I will probably watch it again and again and again. Heather, forgive the length, but I thought it was important. It is very peaceful in the Outer Banks. That's why I go there every year. It's my favorite place on earth. I'm sure there's other places that are just as good, but that's the place that I go. Thank you for that letter, Heather. Where I can't even. All right, this is a long one. Hi, my name is Christian. I am 14 years old and live in Stockholm, Sweden. Wow, Sweden. I love your chilling and grilling videos. I hope I got them in the right order. Recently, my family bought a grill. I don't know what it's called in English, but it runs on gas instead of coal. That's the same thing as mine. Mine runs on propane. Ever since then, I have started grilling a lot. I have grilled chicken, steak, pork, sausage, burgers, and those sticks you put vegetables on, the skewers. They're called kebabs. Anyway, the first chilling and grilling video I saw was when you made chicken wraps. I got really inspired and I found another recipe which had apples and curry. It was delicious, even though I should have cut the apple in a little bit smaller pieces. I have a couple questions. What cars do you drive and what is your dream car? Well, I have a Ford F-150 and a Rogue, and Tom has a Nissan also. He has an Altima. I really see as a role model. What is my dream car? I skipped that one, didn't I? My dream car? If I could have a dream car? Probably just a brand new pickup truck, that's all. I want to be as cool as you when I grow up. I hope this gets featured in fan mail. Well, it did. Good luck with your videos in the future. P.S. You should arm yourself with paintball guns in the future so you can answer the fire in case Jeffrey attacks you. Oh, by the way, I think he was being a jerk about the skit thing, which he agreed to take part on. I thought so too, but that's all over with now. I'm hoping we can move on. And I'm still hoping that he'll be in one of my skits. He says he will, so if he approves the script, I think he will. Dear Larry, my name is Angel and I am from Chicago. This is my first time writing a letter to you. I have some questions. How old is Garfunkel? Garfunkel, to the best of my knowledge, probably 13 years old, 14 years old, somewhere around there. And that's a guess, because she just showed up to our house. We took her to the vet, and the vet guessed at the age at that time. So I'm adding now to it. So I would guess around 13, 14 years old. Will you play GTA next Gaming at the Lounge episode? I don't have it. Tom doesn't have it. I think it says GTA 5. And Tom doesn't have it. I'll have to see if Jesse has it. If not, you know, maybe me and Tom can look into purchasing that. So we'll see. Will you get a Twitter, Insta, or Facebook? I have a personal Facebook, but don't bother trying to, you know, friend me on Facebook. That's my personal thing that I want to keep separate from everybody else, you know. As far as Twitter, Instagram, I already just, you know, I said that earlier that I don't have them and I don't know that I'm going to plan to get one. But if I do, I will definitely make an announcement. What is your favorite game? What kind of game are we talking about? I mean, you have to be more specific than that. Are you talking about video game? Are you talking about game to play, board game? Or are you talking about game and sports? P.S. Sorry for my bad handwriting. Put a security camera by the lounge to keep Jeffrey away. Well, I don't need a security camera outside. I have an alarm system inside the house. That's all I care about. I locked it. I put a lock around the TV when I go away, so I'm not real worried about that either. And I take it in for the winter months anyway. Dear Uncle Larry, I sent you a letter on your fifth fan mail by the video cutoff before you read it. Your camera must have turned off. That sucks. I don't remember. It did it again today to somebody else, so somebody got cut out today. I don't remember much of what I wrote, but I think I'll refresh some questions. I'm looking at the camera right now to make sure it doesn't say that it went off again. Do you like the Philadelphia 76ers? I used to like the 76ers a long, long time ago when Dr. J played on the team. I haven't liked them since. If yes, do you think the new drafts like Jahlil Okafor, I don't even know if I'm pronouncing it right, will make them better? I don't know, they might. I don't watch professional basketball, so I have no idea. Did you know North Carolina is big in basketball? Yes, I did. What city in North Carolina were you in during the trip? I was at Hatteras Island. Sorry to send you this again. Just didn't see you get my questions, and I'm curious to hear your answers. Well, thank you so much. What's your name? Tyler. Appreciate your letter. I hope I answered your questions. And the camera's still on, so your letter definitely got put in this one. All right. Only a few more, folks. I don't need to hear about how long this was either. I know it's long. Dear Uncle Larry, you are one of the best YouTubers. Well, I don't know about all that. I love your chilling and grilling videos. You are a legend. For gaming at the lounge, can you play NBA or Madden? Again, we don't have either one of them. And I'll check to see if Jesse does. I doubt he has them. So we'll see. Who is your favorite college football and basketball teams? College, I always root for Butler in basketball. I don't know what it is about Butler. I love the coach. I always root for him. As far as college football, I don't really watch college football. I watch pro football, and my favorite team is the Eagles. Who is your favorite NBA team? My favorite NBA team used to be the Bulls. It's not that it's not anymore. I just don't watch NBA that much. Who's your favorite NFL team? I just answered that. You are better than Kobe at basketball. No, I'm not. You should do more basketball videos. We just did one yesterday, which I'm sure that you saw. P.S. 313,564 subs. You are definitely getting 1 million. I don't know about that. Also, my favorite NBA team is the Indiana Pacers. My favorite NFL team is the Baltimore Ravens. My favorite NCAA football team is Ohio State Buckeyes. And my favorite NCAA basketball teams are the Ohio State Buckeyes. Notre Dame he likes too. He likes Notre Dame for basketball and football. All right, awesome. Thank you, Blaine. Well, that's an interesting last name. I'm not going to say it, but it's... What's this guy there? Oh, wait a second, folks. I got a penny here from 1991. Not sure what's on it, but... Let's see. Dear Larry, hi, my name is Maddox. I am 11 years old and I love your videos. They are awesome. I would love it if you had another family trip to Detroit, Michigan. That's where I am from. Could you do a house tour? And also, can you do a chilling and grilling homemade pizza breadsticks? Sincerely, Maddox. Family trip to Detroit, Michigan? I don't know about that. Could you do a house tour? I don't know about that. I'd have to clean the house, the whole house first before I would do something like that. That's a lot of work. Homemade pizza and breadsticks? I'm not good at making pizza, so I don't know that you'll ever see that. P.S. Jeffrey went to Larry's Lounge and put a beer bottle behind your TV. He also took your Larry's Lounge sign while you were in North Carolina. Okay, he must have wrote this a while ago, because that's old news. Thank you. I hope that's a lucky penny. You didn't even say anything about the penny in the envelope, so not sure about that. All right. This is from Texas. And it's a long one. You can read and show this on your video. My name is Kim, and I live in Waco, Texas. I'm 32, I'm married and have 3 kids. I'm subscribed to you and McJuggernuggets. I love how you're so down to earth and you're very true to your fans and everyone else. Just by watching your videos, I feel like you're an uncle to me. I agree with you about all this hate. Life is too short for it. I also feel the same about bullies. I lost all my hair when I was 11. I don't know how to pronounce that word, but it's alopecia or something like that. So I was teased and bullied a lot, but I've overcome it. I have my health and family, and that's all that matters. Maybe when I buy one of your bandanas, you can sign it for me. That would be cool. Also, sorry about your lounge sign. That was not cool. Thank you for your time. Keep up your videos. You are awesome. Your number one fan, Kim. P.S. Tell Tom I said hi and pet Garfunkel for me. I certainly will. I will tell Tom hi and pet Garfunkel. I'm sorry to hear about, you know, the thing that you had to deal with in your life. I know how mean kids can be. It's a shame that people are like that in general. It's funny because, you know, I came home and I always look at the comments section for some reason, just to check out things. And I notice a lot of bad comments on the basketball thing. So many people are critical and they say, you guys are horrible at basketball, blah, 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 all this. And it's like, and then somebody wrote something about, you know, he noticed that Uncle Larry's really shitty on the comments towards other, you know, comments and stuff. And it's like, I didn't think I really was. I think if I get comments that are happy and all that stuff, I usually comment back pretty happy. But if somebody's going to say shitty things to me, I usually have a tendency to say shitty things back to them, only because that's how I grew up in my generation. That's what you did. A real man talked face to face to another man, not through a computer writing stuff down. So it's hard for me to get over that and realize that. I'm having a real hard time with the comment section. I'm actually debating whether I should abandon even writing or even reading the comment section and just deal with fan mail and that's it. Tell me what you think about that and we'll see where I go. I've been watching all your content since you started. I like your caveman skit and chilling and grilling. I drew a picture. I hope you like it. You should do a skit with Jesse and Tom all in one. I have one planned out too. It's just that, you know, to get time for to get all every, you know, to get Jesse together with us is really hard. You should do a skit with, oh, I read that, all in one. I tried to keep this short since you don't like reading long things. That's about it. Your vids are awesome, and I think you need more subs. Thank you so much, Jaden. I really appreciate that. What a great letter. And I do appreciate the shorter letters. If you guys can keep them short, I really appreciate that. Then I wouldn't sweat like this out here if they were real short. No, I would still be sweating. Ballin' like Larry. Want a beer? I don't speak Tomish. Welcome to Larry's Lounge. That's awesome. Tomish. It is a hard language to learn. I'm still working on it. I haven't mastered it yet. I haven't even come close to it. But it is a hard language to learn. Okay. Dear Uncle Larry, hello, my name is Chris. I'm 14 years old and I'm a huge fan of your channel as well as McJuggernuggets and unfortunately Big Brother. Congrats on 100,000 subs, that's a great award. Anyway, from one of Jesse's videos you mentioned that you were a Chicago Bulls fan. Are you still a fan or are you a Sixers fan? I'm from Illinois and I've been a Bulls fan ever since I could remember. Thanks for reading my letter and tell Tom and Garfunkel I said hi. Like seriously, tell Garfunkel I said hi. And seriously, I will. P.S. Could I have your autograph? Stamp included. Oh, you did include a stamp. Yes, I will. I will sign. I will sign your letter and send it back to you. That's what I will do. And I appreciate your letter. And am I a Bulls fan still? No. I don't watch NBA. At all. I'm very disheartened with the NBA. The ashes are, you guys don't realize this. I do this over top of my fire pit right here. Because if I ever did get hate, I'd be like, shh, and light it up and put it in the fire pit. All right, my camera just cut off again. I don't know if I got the last letter in or not. It was from Samir. I think that's how you pronounce it right. S-A-M-I-R. If I didn't get your letter in there, I'm sorry. I won't know until I edit this. It's freaking camera. It's not the camera. I think it's the SD cards. I got to get some new ones. They act up and they just stop recording for whatever reason. So anyway, that's been fan mail today. Thank you guys so much for sending me fan mail. I really appreciate it. Let me put my glasses back on. I really appreciate all the fan mail that I get. Again, if you want to purchase t-shirts, excuse all the sweat that I have pouring off me. If you want to purchase t-shirts, hats, bandanas, I'm coming out with a few new shirts. They probably won't be until Monday, Tuesday next week, probably. Hopefully they come in time this weekend, the shirts and the transfers. I think you guys will like them. If not this week, check it out next week. Anyway, if you'd like to buy one, go to our store there. It's going to be in the description. Other than that, I just ask for you that you subscribe for more. If you like the content here, sorry this video was so long, but I don't feel like I should leave any letters out. Till next time, grab yourself a cold one, put your feet up. I'll meet you at the lounge. Cheers. One question, is it true that you will make your lounge bigger, extending all the way to your pool like you mentioned one time? Be sure to check out Rooster Teeth Productions and their series called RT Shorts. They are funny like your skit. Sincerely, Isaac, or my YouTube user, Mr. Chief 117. Is it true that I will make my lounge bigger? Yeah, I said that, I think I said it one or two videos ago. Yeah, I plan on going out this way eventually. Well, actually, my grill over there is going to have a countertop and everything. I am going to go out this way with another level, probably one step up higher, and it's going to have eventually a hot tub on it, and then that'll have a pathway leading to a deck that's going to go to the other side of my pool. That's my plan. When it gets done, I'm not really sure. I have to have the time and the extra funds for that, but when I do that, I'll be pretty excited about it because I really would like to have a hot tub. Okay, so here's from, I thought I cut all of them open, obviously I didn't, from Jonathan. This one already came with a slit in it. So I hope you didn't send me anything, because if you did, it's most probably not in here. Hi Uncle Larry, my name is Jonathan. I've been a subscriber ever since you did Welcome to Larry's Lounge. I love your Chillin' and Grillin' series. Your chicken sandwiches were delicious. I really appreciate you taking the time to read this and featuring it on your fan mail. I really appreciate the time that you took to write this too. P.S. I would appreciate if you and Tom could sign this and return it. I will provide a stamp for it. I also included a bottle opener. Hopefully you can use it daily. Well, the bottle opener obviously did not make it. Let me see if the stamp did. I think there's something else in here. No, well, there's another piece of paper in here. Oh, there is a stamp in here. I don't know how I'm going to peel that off and put that back on the envelope, but please accept this bottle opener as a gift to you for my recent vacation to Florida. Cheers, drink responsible. Thank you for that. Unfortunately, your bottle opener didn't make it. It got opened and somebody took it out of there. Probably because when you send something like that through the regular mail, it's a sharp object and somebody's going to open it and take it out of there. Your stamp did make it, however, and I will definitely have me and Tom sign that and we will send that back to you. It's a shame because I would have really enjoyed a bottle opener from Florida. I will put that one aside. Dear Uncle Larry, my name is Michael. I am 14 years old from New Jersey, and I love your channel. Whenever I'm watching your episodes from Chillin' and Grillin', I just want to eat my laptop. Tell Tom and Jesse I said hi, and maybe even Mr. Ridgeway. P.S. I hope he's not that I give will only be if you write it in a letter, because if I had to give a shout out to every person, I've said this in countless other videos that it would like take forever. Larry's Lounge, loungers, chillers, bowlers, and grillers. There it is. Nice, thank you so much. Thank you for your letter. And I appreciate it. If you can see all the sweat stains, it's hot out today. Okay, here we go. Dear Uncle Larry, you're way more better being a father than Psycho Dad. I'm sorry about how Jeffrey treated you during the Kung Fu skit. He acts like a 5-year-old. Some of his brain connections isn't functioning right. Tom is really awesome and Garfunkel is really cute, even though she looks like a mop. Yeah, she does kind of look like a mop, doesn't she? I like cats. I'm a cat person. I showed some clips of Garfunkel to my dad. My dad's a Gulf War veteran. Hope you're having a good day from Christopher. Christopher, tell your dad that I said thank you for his service. The reason why this country is so great as it is because of men like him. So I thank you. Okay, here we go. Let's see what we got here. We got all kinds of stuff. Dear Larry, I don't know if I should call you Uncle Larry. Feel free to call me Uncle Larry. I've been an uncle ever since I was like 10 years old, so it doesn't bother me in the least bit. I'm very comfortable with that. Hello, my name is Alex. I'm going to keep this short and sweet because personally, I don't like reading long letters. Me and you both, but I've been trying. This is the first fan mail that I've ever sent to anyone. Wow, that's awesome. You are my idol. I love how you're caring for everyone. I have some questions for you. How old were you when you got into basketball? I think I've answered that quite a few times. And it's probably like 8 years old. And I'm guessing at that age, I know I was very young. My brothers taught me how to play. Did you get your recipes from your father, and did he get it from his father, etc.? Some of the recipes that I do are family recipes. I don't think I've gotten any of my recipes from my dad, though. Some of them aren't. Some of them are just like when I watch the Food Network or I saw something I really liked, and then I'll add it or change something a little bit to it just to make it my own. And never be afraid to experiment with different spices and stuff like that and try different things out. Are you thinking of getting any social media accounts such as Twitter and Instagram? That brings up a great point. I'm glad that you actually said that. I just had gotten a message through work from somebody whose son bought a t-shirt or was buying a t-shirt that they donated money to one of those fake ass Uncle Larry's on Twitter because they said that if you give money they'll give an autograph for it. I would never charge money for an autograph. It's just my signature. If anybody wants my autograph, I'd be more than happy to do it. If you bought a t-shirt and you wanted it signed, make sure you just say that. I'll sign the t-shirt or bandana or hat or whatever. I have no... Hey everybody, welcome to the lounge. All my fellow loungers, chillers, bowlers, and grillers. Today's fan mail at the lounge. We're going to jump right into it, but first I just want to let you know I actually opened all the letters up first so that this way I don't have to go through that process. The first one's from Alex. This envelope was all tore up when I got it. So, let's see what you got to say, Alex. I am writing you to... Oh, excuse me, I have to take my glasses off. Oh, and just one more thing. A lot of people have been saying, who the hell takes their glasses off? Me, that's who. I'm nearsighted, I have problems with distance, but reading-wise, if I take them off, I can read just fine, so... I am writing to you from the Big Apple. Whom do you prefer? Billy Joel, Elton John, Beach Boys, or Vanilla Ice? Out of those four, it's a tie between Billy Joel and Elton John. Never cared for the Beach Boys. Don't care for Vanilla Ice either. I think, what do you have, one good song? And was it really good? Anyway, let's go Rangers. Pull tab on pen. Well, obviously, don't know what you're talking about because there's no pen. Hope all is well. Tell Jesse I said hi. Hope you and JT get along and it would make everything better. P.S. Keep this flashlight with you. Alex the Juggeroni. Juggy Caroni. There was no flashlight in here. Like I said, this is how the envelope came all tore up. You have to remember, that's what happens when you send things inside of an envelope. Sometimes they can just disappear before I ever get it. So, all right, let's go to the next one. If anybody's saying, "Yo, Uncle Larry, you look down today." No, I'm not down. I'm perfectly fine. I'm just really, really tired. I still haven't recovered from basketball the other day. We played 4-on-4, full court, quite a few games, so I'm really tired. All right, this one. I got a patch in here from Panama City Beach Stair Climb FDNY Memorial. And a firefighter, I guess it's a commemorative coin or something. That's pretty awesome. Can't wait to read this one. "Hey Uncle Larry, I'm a firefighter, EMT from Florida. I'm also a chiller, griller, and baller. Congrats on your recent 300,000 subscribers. I tried finding you my old first responder patch but couldn't. Instead, I gave you a sticker I got last September during the all-stair climb. We had to climb 110 stories over here in Panama City Beach to simulate what FDNY had to go through." Wow, no problem with that. If you wanted it through the mail, the only way I'm going to send it to you is if you send me a self-addressed stamped envelope for me to send it back. I'd be more than happy to do that if you wanted that. You know, personally, I don't understand why anybody wants my autograph. But I just want you guys to know that, since he brought up about Twitter, I do not have Twitter. I do not have Instagram. Don't know if I'm ever going to get either one of them. But if I did, believe me, I will make a public announcement on a video. So remember, keep away from them fake-ass Uncle Larrys. "Also, as a little idea for your channel, can you do a Q&A or a chilling and growing with Jesse's dad?" That's not going to happen. "Also, can you autograph the picture I sent you from you, Tom, and Jesse? Can you also..." Oh, I forgot that he sent. There's Tom. There's Jesse. And there's me. And I would love to, if you would have sent me a self-stamped envelope with these pictures, I would have. And for now on, I also want to make another announcement. I would be more than willing, I most probably will do this for you, Alex, this time, but in the future, please send me a self-stamped envelope, self-addressed stamped envelope. I am not going to ask for Jesse to sign anything. It's just too much for me to take, get a hold of him. The best way I could say is, you know, send him a letter, try to get his autograph that way, but I'm not going to be going back and forth, so... If you want mine, it's fine. If you want Jesse's, that's quite different. So keep that in mind, guys. I'll put that aside. Me and Tom will be happy to send those. Okay, here's a baseball card from Juan Berenger of Atlanta. Not a big Atlanta fan, because I like the Phillies, but Atlanta's always has been a really good team. "Dear Uncle Larry, hi, my name is Tanner. I live in the state of Washington. I wanted to let you know that you make my day. Awesome. I love to watch your videos. I love your basketball videos. They taught me a lot of new and cool stuff. My favorite is In the Gaming with Tom. I also like the skits. P.S. Number one fan." Thank you, Tanner, and I appreciate the card. And thank you for the mail. My number one fan. Okay, this is from Isaac. Looks like he's from California. "Uncle Larry, sorry for the bad handwriting. My name is Isaac. I may not be old enough to open the same beverage as you, but I love your videos. I might not have as bad days as some of your other viewers, but they sure do make me happy. I have 110 stories. And I just complain about playing like 5 games of basketball. It makes me feel pretty stupid right now. We wore our full bunker gear and toughed it out. I got a few t-shirts and stuff, but none in your size. I also attached a challenge coin. Google it and you'll understand what it is. Fire Ice is the company. One of my family members works for it. It is pretty much a fire retardant service. It is truly amazing. Check it out. Love from Rosewood Fire Department. Keep up the great videos, Uncle Larry. Wow, thank you so much for this letter and this stuff, and I will Google it and find out what that is. Also, thank you for your service of what you do, because it's guys like you who are really the true heroes in the United States, the people who are serving other people like that. That's awesome. Okay, let's see. I have to make sure I don't show the envelope like this, because it's like, Uncle Larry, you showed the address. It's like, yeah, there's too much stuff to remember all the time. Dear Larry's Lounge, my name is Caleb, and I love your videos. The first video of yours I saw was Chillin' and Grillin' 6, Lamb Chops. I really want to try your food, so after I write this letter, I'm going to ask my mom to make it. I'm really sorry that Jeffrey destroyed your sign. Yeah, me too. I hope you get a new one, eventually. Right now I have a piece of cardboard up there. I have gotten a couple signs, but the only one that's going to replace my sign is the one that I make. My dad is a bit of a cook himself, and he makes really good pot roast. I put the recipe on the back if you want to try it. Hopefully you can read this in fan mail at the lounge 5 or 6. Sincerely, Caleb. P.S. Sorry for my bad handwriting. Your handwriting's not that bad. I could read it, so it's not that bad. So anyway, so your pot roast, I will definitely look into this when I get a chance to and see if I can't make that. Try it out. I always like to try new stuff, so. All right, well, my SD card just messed up again and it stopped recording. I looked up at the camera and it had stopped. I have no idea when. I have to apologize to anybody whose letter got cut off because I'm gonna have to edit that. It absolutely sucks. Somebody told me what's going on. I gotta buy different cards. Anyway, this one's from Dustin. Hey Uncle Larry, I've basically watched all your videos, but I have a few to go. You are like my video cookbook. Sorry if that sounds weird. Plus, I hope in the future I can buy one of your shirts and hats. I do have a question. Will you grill any breakfast? I most probably will at some point. My name is Dustin. I'm also a fellow YouTuber. I'm 16, but still enjoy your content. I do have a different type of channel. My YouTube name is Dustin Watkins. If you want to go check it out, if you'd like. If it's not any trouble, can you give me a shout out? You just kind of got one. Well, I hope you write back, but if not, then I'm fine with that. Thank you for reading this. Sincerely, Dustin. P.S. I'm not a drawer, so I did what I could. I wish I didn't have to fold it though. Yeah, the shout out.